Okay, let's continue. Now that you've got an idea of how an endo 2 works, what we're going to do is start applying various normals or detailed normals across other parts of this torso here or body. Let me just double check. Let's make sure I enable that. This is our color. That's our UV. I'm going to start. Well, let me add some fabric down around the legs here. And because we already have a fabric texture or fabric normal here, I'm just going to copy and pull that down right here. All right, and what I can do is I can just delete the part I don't need, like that. Okay, so I've got this piece, and holding Alt and clicking the I button allows you to solo different layers. What I'm trying to do, so I'm trying to add it on top there. I'm just going to turn it to a let's make it a linear dodge so that I can see where I'm putting it. Or maybe something a little less intense than that. Hard light. Maybe something else. something like that. Okay, close enough. Just use that. All right, so with that down right there, and I'm looking at just this pants area here. I go ahead, copy and paste it across like that. And use my erase tool. Just to go ahead and clear and clone it together or blend it together, something like that. And I know it doesn't look like it makes any sense right now, that's fine. Do the same over here. Might move that over there actually. Do that over here. Okay, let me change this back to normal. Then I'll combine these together. So 1, 2, 3, Control E, like that. And now I'm just going to select. We'll use my magic wand to select this area here. So use the magic wand like that and go back up to the normals. And what we want is Control Shift I to invert the selection and delete the normal maps on the outside. Okay, so now we have the normal maps there. I want to blend it with everything else. So let's go overlay and there we have it. Oops, overlay. Keep forgetting to do that properly. So that's good. So if I zoom in, you can see the fabric is now right there. Okay? So really good. All right. Let's try something else. Let's try. Well, I want to leave the kilt until a little bit later. All right? Because I need to add some extra, well, just a bit of extra detail. For example, over here, you can see we've got some green splashes, these little ornaments coming down. That's what I'll be doing. I'll be creating that, but I need to create the diffuse of that first. So we'll leave that for now. Let's try some leather. So with leather, what I'm going to do is go to my textures folder and search for a leather texture. And this leather texture will help me get that very nice, subtle looking, subtle leather feel. So something like this one, perhaps. We'll grab it. If you want a older version, you can go ahead and grab that one. But all these textures you see right here, they're from cgtextures.com. So go ahead and grab that. Now I've got this leather texture here. Let me use Endo 2 again. Just open it up. All right. And with this window still open, I'm going to go to presets. And let's keep this simple. I might use, well, I'll probably use leather cushion. Let's give that a try. Got other presets there as well. I'll just try to use the ones that match the current material that I'll be using. So it will take a few minutes depending on how big the image is. This one's quite large, which is fine. So the larger for me, the better. That way I can get a little bit more resolution out of those details. And these details are going to be very subtle, okay? Of course, you can sculpt those details using your sculpting tool. But I like to use Endo 2 because it allows me to get quicker results. Okay, so I can preview them a little bit quicker. But if you want something very specific for, say, for example, a very high level character or AAA character, then definitely use your, sculpting tool to get those results. Okay, so here's our leather. It's very harsh. You can see there's a lot of bumps there. We actually want this to be very subtle. Okay, so what I want to do is let me go to the Endo 2 here. Let's reduce some of the large volumes, or turn the large volumes down. Maybe loosen the skin. Might also mess around with the large indent, so the indentations are a little bit too harsh. Same with medium volume and soft folds. Might turn medium volume off completely, actually. Maybe base folds we can also turn down, and that's looking much nicer. Okay, a lot more like actual leather. Well, in this context, it'll be leather armor. I turn down sharp folds as well. Maybe a little bit of the skin, and I think that's pretty good. Not bad. By the way, you can adjust the opacity later, so you might want to have a little bit more detail, a little bit more intensity than you usually do. I'm going to turn the base folds down again. Maybe bring sharp folds up. Skin. Yep, it's looking good. You got your preview here. Great. All right, let's close Endo 2. We're done with that, at least for this piece. I'm going to merge those layers together and copy. Let's just close the leather thing down. We can bring that up later. And copy and paste. This will be leather. We're going to apply it to the appropriate areas. First, it will be the armor. Depending on how much detail you need, you might want to just double check the amount of detail you're adding there. So I'm going to shrink it down substantially so it's very subtle, very small. This will give it nice readability. That's pretty good. Great. Of course, I want to duplicate it to the other side over here. Great. And down here, what I want to do is just apply it to these two. So just use a polygon select tool like that. Oops. Shift, Control, I, and delete. So we're keeping the inside and deleting the outside. Now for these two, same deal. Let me just merge these all together. I'm gonna go to my magic wand, select this area. Oops, might have to go to the base. Select that area. You can select that if you want as well. Turn on normals, go to my leather, invert the selection, Control Shift I, and delete. Right, and over here, I might do the same, like that. So that is now the leather piece. Now I've got a little bit of a edge over here, but that's okay because it's actually not part of the, it's not part of the UV. I might just clone stamp that. Clone stamp it out just to be safe. All right, so that leather's looking good. Let's go ahead and turn this to an overlay and see what's the result. So that result looks pretty nice already. All right, I'm quite pleased with it. All right, what else can we do? Well, we can apply the leather down here on the shoe. This will, of course, be even more subtle. So let's go ahead, copy, paste that down here. Same deal as before. I'm going to shrink it. Maybe spin it on its horizontal axes. Like that. Might resize it as well. So something like that will do. Enter. Clone it. Put it on the other side, like that. And of course, don't want to forget the bottom part of this down here as well. Let me turn off normals, go to my base. So that's the brand new color there. Turn my normals back on. Let's start deleting things. Delete. Great. And from here, what I want to do is erase the segments that aren't that relevant. Okay, this piece, just so that I can blend that in. That's looking pretty good. Merge this together. This will be leather boots and change it to overlay. All right. And of course, you can just change the opacity. It's a little bit harsh, so I want it to be even more subtle than what I have on the armor there. So the boots should be something like that. Okay, maybe even more. Very, very subtle. That's looking pretty good. So you kind of get the idea. We're doing things piece by piece, applying it in, and then later on, and I promise you it'll be a lot of fun, we'll be doing texturing using Dido. And by the way, it's gonna be really fast. Let's do one more, and I might try the torso piece, torso armor right here. Again, constantly using that UV map as a guide. Okay, over here, I'm going to break it down like that. Great. So that's the bottom one done. Let's try the back of the armor, which is this piece. Up here, same deal. Okay, I'm going to merge those two together and then go back and delete the borders. All right. Turn on normals. Control-Shift-I, delete the outside part, so we only have the inside, and then turn this to an overlay. I'm going to call it leather chest armor. Important to rename these as you go, otherwise it might get a little bit confusing. That's not too bad if it is a little bit too harsh. So like the boots, I'm going to turn them down slightly. And if you want, I might be a little bit more adventurous. I'm going to go to filter and blur this. So I might try Gaussian blur. 66 is too harsh, so maybe something like that. So 0.6. So it's nice and blurry. All right. Now, if you're curious as to what this is going to look like now, let me export these normals. We'll go ahead, save it as a targa in the same file, N. And by the way, I should change the defuse to a D postfix. Great. Back into Maya. Let's go to my hypershade. So this is before. Hopefully it will reload right now. So this is before, the normal map's before. You can see we've got the fabric on the shoulders there. Obviously the colors are still flat, that's okay. If I go back into the normals, so expand the nodes, go to the file and reload. And let's see what we get. So go ahead, reload, take a few seconds. And there you have it, that's the leather armor. It's starting to really pop out, it's looking really nice. So the combination of that macro detail and micro detail coming together gives it an extremely readable effect. So you got the fabric on the pants as well. Obviously, it's a little too shiny. That will be changed very soon. And over here, we've got the normals on the boots. All right. Really good. Quite pleased with this. All right. We'll continue on in the next video.